Far off the coast of Yorkshire, a monumental shift in renewable energy is taking place. The Dogger Bank Wind Farm, set to become the world's largest offshore wind farm, is steadily rising from the depths of the North Sea. This colossal project, spanning 130 to 200 kilometers from shore, will generate enough power to supply 6 million UK homes. Construction began with installing enormous 72-meter-long monopile foundations designed to withstand the North Sea's harsh conditions. Despite facing challenges like adverse weather and supply chain delays, the team has successfully installed the first of the Haliade-X turbines, which stand as tall as skyscrapers and capture massive amounts of wind energy. As Dogger Bank inches closer to full operation, one question remains. How is this groundbreaking project overcoming obstacles to redefine the future of renewable energy? The United Kingdom, like many nations, is grappling with the urgent need to transition to renewable energy sources. Fossil fuels, with their detrimental impact on the environment, are becoming increasingly untenable. The country's ambitious targets for reducing carbon emissions necessitate bold and innovative solutions. Enter Dogger Bank, a project that promises not just to meet, but to exceed expectations. The story of Dogger Bank began over a decade ago. Initially envisioned as four offshore wind farms, each with a capacity of up to 1.2 gigawatts, the project has evolved significantly. Today, it consists of multiple phases, with the first three, Dogger Bank A, B, and C, underway. The combined capacity of these phases is set to reach 3.6 gigawatts, enough to power millions of homes with clean, renewable energy. But what makes Dogger Bank particularly special? Its location in the North Sea offers unique advantages. Far from shore, it avoids the common aesthetic objections to wind turbines while taking advantage of relatively shallow waters, which are ideal for traditional fixed foundation designs. This combination of factors makes Dogger Bank an optimal site for large-scale offshore wind energy production. In 2019, the project secured significant financial backing and began its journey toward becoming a reality. By October 2023, the wind farm had started producing electricity, marking a significant milestone. This achievement is just the beginning, as the construction and installation of more turbines and infrastructure continue at a rapid pace. Let's start with the foundations. In July 2022, the first monopile foundation was installed, marking a critical milestone. Each of these foundations is over 72 meters long and weighs around 1,057 tons. To put that into perspective, each foundation is longer than six double-decker buses, lined up end-to-end and as heavy as nearly 200 elephants. These foundations are designed to handle the challenging wave loads and harsh conditions of the North Sea, ensuring the stability of the wind turbines above. Installing these foundations is a meticulous process. They are transported from Rotterdam to the offshore site using specialized vessels equipped with dynamic positioning technology. This technology ensures the vessel remains perfectly positioned over the installation site despite the waves and wind. Once in position, a monopile is upended and transferred to a pile gripper, then lowered into the seabed. A massive hammer drives the monopile into the seabed to the required depth, creating a stable base. Afterward, a unique split-level transition piece is attached to the monopile using 152 giant bolts. This piece includes the world's largest 8-meter flange, which connects the monopile to the turbine tower, ensuring everything fits together perfectly and remains watertight. The transition piece design is innovative. It allows technicians to safely access the turbine towers directly from service vessels, eliminating many manual handling activities and lifting operations over the lifetime of the wind farm. This design feature significantly enhances safety and efficiency, showing the project's commitment to not only building, but also maintaining a world-class wind farm. Once the foundations are in place, the focus shifts to installing the wind turbines themselves. The Dogger Bank Wind Farm will use GE Renewable Energy's groundbreaking Haliade-X turbines. These turbines are some of the most powerful in the world, capable of producing substantial amounts of electricity. Installation of these turbines began in the spring of 2023. Each turbine stands tall, with blades that can sweep an area equivalent to 7 football fields. These blades capture wind energy and convert it into electricity, which is then transmitted back to shore. To get the electricity from these offshore turbines to homes and businesses onshore, high-voltage direct current HVDC cables are used. Almost 73 miles of these cables have been installed in the East Riding of Yorkshire. These cables are crucial for efficiently transmitting the electricity generated by the turbines over long distances. The installation process for these cables began with ground preparation, trenching, and drilling. Protective ducts were then installed, followed by the HVDC cables themselves. This meticulous process ensures that the electricity generated offshore can be reliably delivered to the national grid. The onshore construction also involves building converter stations. These stations convert the electricity from HVDC to HVAC current, which is suitable for transmission through the UK grid network. The first two phases of the Dogger Bank wind farm will connect to the grids near Beverley in East Riding of Yorkshire, while the third phase will connect near Redcar in the Tees Valley. These converter stations are essential for ensuring that the electricity generated by the wind farm can be used to power homes and businesses across the UK. One of the most groundbreaking features of the Dogger Bank project is the world's first unmanned HVDC offshore substation. This innovative platform, installed in April 2023, is a marvel of engineering. It is designed to be controlled remotely from shore and accessed only by service vessels. By eliminating the need for living quarters, helideck, and sewage systems, the platform's weight is reduced by 70% per megawatt compared to previous platforms. This lean design results in significant cost savings and increased efficiency. The Dogger Bank wind farm is designed to power 6 million UK homes once completed. This massive project is divided into three phases, Dogger Bank A, B, and C. Each phase will connect to the grid, ensuring a steady supply of renewable energy. Throughout the construction process, local resources and expertise have been utilized extensively. For example, the steel used in the transition pieces comes from Wales, highlighting the project's commitment to supporting local industries. The project also involves a significant amount of onshore work, including the installation of HVAC cables and the construction of converter stations. Offshore, the installation of the turbine foundations and subsea HVDC cables is a complex and carefully coordinated effort. Each step in the process is designed to ensure the highest standards of safety and efficiency. From the initial ground preparation and drilling to the installation of the HVDC cables and converter stations, every detail is meticulously planned and executed. As the turbines begin to generate electricity, the project continues to make significant progress. The offshore and onshore teams work tirelessly to ensure that every aspect of the wind farm is constructed to the highest standards. However, due to challenging weather conditions, vessel availability issues, and supply chain delays, Dogger Bank A may not be fully operational until 2025. Despite these setbacks, the team is committed to meeting its targets and delivering this groundbreaking project. As of early 2024, 12 turbines have been installed at Dogger Bank A, with the first turbine producing power in October 2023. Despite the delays, the Dogger Bank wind farm continues to make strides. Monopile installation for Dogger Bank B is set to begin soon, following the completion of preparatory work. Looking ahead, the project is set to expand further with Dogger Bank D, a proposed fourth phase that could add up to 2 gigawatts of capacity. This phase is part of a broader capacity improvement program aimed at maximizing renewable energy output from existing seabed leases. The Dogger Bank D project plans to utilize the eastern portion of the current seabed lease area to significantly increase energy production. This expansion involves detailed environmental assessments to ensure the protection of marine habitats, while enhancing the wind farm's contribution to the UK's renewable energy targets. By integrating this additional capacity, Dogger Bank will play an even more crucial role in the nation's energy landscape, driving the shift towards a more sustainable future. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, comment, and turn on notifications to stay updated on the latest projects.